try to find the end of road construction in Osceola County, you won't find it. The county has a wish list of $500 million for pedestrian and bike lanes and trails, and $250 million for sidewalks. And that's not the big expense during the next decade.
We have $1.1 billion worth of road construction that needs just widening two lanes to four lanes, just to make sure that our residents can get around.
That's why county commissioners put to voters a referendum that would raise the sales tax by a penny to 8.5%, the highest sales tax in the region. That'll generate $67 million a year, not just for roads, but for expanded Lynx bus routes and possibly to pay operating costs for Sunrail. But the community is split on the tax hike. Some say it's too much on top of a max 11% local option gas tax. It's even split families. Sophia Ramirez is against it, her dad for it.
And I just don't think it's fair. I think that within the development process, they should have already included those costs within their projects.
Have to do something for the roads.
Osceola is already collecting a penny sales tax that's paying for public safety, drainage, and roads, and another half cent for schools. Through the weekend, nearly 30,000 people had voted early or by mail-in ballot. That's nearly 14%.
Typically about half of our voters vote prior to election day, so we're hoping that will put us around 25-28% by the end of tomorrow.
And you can see by these signs, which are, by the way, all over Osceola County, both for and against the sales tax, the supervisor's office believes because this is such a controversial measure, that should drive up turnout during election day tomorrow. Coming up all new on Washington News at 5:30, we'll take a look not only more at this tax, the Volusia County proposed tax, but also other sales taxes in the region and where that money is going. Live in Osceola County, Greg Fox, Washington News.